By the end of July 2020, the following enhanced aircraft deployments were seen in the two main Chinese airfields that will be used to launch operations over Ladakh. Both are in Xinjiang and the airfields are situated in Kashgar and Hotan. Kashgar is about 700 kilometers northwest of Ladakh, while Hotan is situated about 400 kilometers north of Ladakh. Let us first look at some details about each airbase and the combat aircraft that have been spotted there. We start with Hotan, which will be the primary source of attacks in the northwest in case of conflict. By end July, a total of 56 fighters and 4 ELINT or AWACS aircraft were stationed there. Hotan is situated at an altitude of 1,400 meters. It has a single 3-kilometer long runway, but the Chinese are building a new runway parallel to and to the south of the existing runway. The most significant aircraft seen at Hotan in July 2020 were 24 Sukhoi Su-27 copies, probably J-11s, parked in two separate areas. These are primarily air defense fighters with adequate range to show a presence over Ladakh. However, they will be limited to a defensive role and they will not be able to maintain 24 hours a day combat air patrol over Ladakh, leaving free gaps in air cover which can be exploited by the Indian Air Force. In addition, we can see, parked on the apron at Hotan, 27 MiG-21 copies that the Chinese call J-7. These will probably only be used for local air defense. They do not have the range to reach Ladakh and return. There are also 6 J-8s parked in Hotan. J-8s are described as trouble-prone aircraft with a poor weapon suite and an inefficient engine. Their range is also poor and they are unlikely to be seen over Ladakh. One significant group of 4 aircraft seen in Hotan are 2 KJ-500 AWACS aircraft and 2 Y-8 GX-4 ELINT aircraft. The capabilities and limitations of Chinese AWACS over Ladakh have been described by me in a detailed video on this channel. Please see that for details. This is an image of the Kashgar airfield. It is a civilian airport that is also used by the PLAAF. It is situated at an altitude of 1,400 meters. It has a 3-kilometer long main runway and a 2.7-kilometer long parallel taxi track that could be used in emergencies if the main runway is out of action. On the apron on one side are parked 6 H-6 bombers. The H-6 bomber is a copy of the old Soviet Tu-16 Badger. It is a Cold War relic, which is a little bigger and heavier than a Boeing 737-300. It cannot fly very high or very fast and will show up as a huge target on radar. It can carry free-fall nuclear bombs or anti-ship cruise missiles, but in the Indian context, it can deliver about 9 tons of bombs, which translates into about 18 1,000-pound bombs. This is as much as 3 Jaguar aircraft can deliver. The range of the H-6 to target and back is about 1,500 kilometers, but because of its huge size and slow speed, these bombers are unlikely to be able to fly very far into Indian airspace before they are intercepted. On the other side of the apron in Kashgar are 13 JH-7 attack fighters. 2 seem to be missing from the apron, so the total is probably 15. The JH-7 is a Chinese development from the 1980s to serve an attack role similar to the Jaguar. It is a third-generation aircraft that uses a Chinese license-built version of the British Rolls-Royce Spey engine. However, However, it has some modern avionics and is said to have fly-by-wire controls. At best, it can carry a 9-ton weapon load of bombs and unguided rocket pods in addition to guns, but that gets reduced to about 5 tons when it has a full fuel load. On full fuel, it is said to have a combat radius of 900 kilometers, which would put Ladakh at the limit of its range from Kashgar. With a low thrust-to-weight ratio and high wing loading, it is unlikely that the JH-7 can operate out of Tibet airfields. The aircraft will be no match for any Indian air defense fighter. Those who are interested can watch my assessment of Chinese air bases in another video on this channel. Meanwhile, do share this video and subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching.